have our Microsoft Azure portal here. We're going to go into the Microsoft Entra ID service. Start on the left under Manage. Go into App Registrations. We're going to create a registration for a mobile device application. So we hit New Registration at the top. I'm going to name it something like that. Hit Register. Okay, this brings us to our App Registration Overview. On the left-hand side, we're going to go to Authentication under Manage, Allow Public Client Flows. I'm going to hit Yes. And then we're going to add a platform. And this is where you can choose whether it's going to be an iOS, Android device, or mobile and desktop applications. In this case, mobile desktop applications, that's what I'm going to pick. Each one of those has different redirect URLs, which you can find on the Microsoft Learn article. In this case, I'm looking for the one under the Create a Web Service Application in Microsoft Entra ID. And under the steps here, you see the link that you need. I copy that and then paste it here. And hit Configure. Once that's done, I can save. So after adding your platform, we're going to go over to the left to manage API permissions. We're going to add Dynamics ERP. So under clicking Add Permission, search for Dynamics ERP, go ahead and click on that. I'm going to do Delegated Permissions, and I'm going to select the Custom Service .full access. All right, after that, back to our tenant up here. Under Manage, we're going to go to Enterprise Applications. I'm going to search for the application we just created. Industrial mobile device. We're going to go over Manage. We're going to hit Properties. And we're going to make the assignment required say yes, and visible to users say yes, hit Save. And then after we do that, we're going to go over to Users and Groups. I'm going to add a user or group. In this case, I'm just going to add a specific user. I'm going to go ahead and search for my username because I'm going to add myself as a user. Hit select and hit assign. Okay, now we've got users assigned. I'm going over to the security section, going to permissions. We're going to grant admin consent for RSM, that tenant. After you click this link as the administrator, you're going to sign in as yourself and click accept. Once that's done, go ahead and click refresh. And Dynamics ERP should now show up under here and under the APIs. Okay, so that's all the setup that we need to do. Now we need to go find the information for the mobile device. So I'm going to go ahead and set up the connection over here. I'm going to do input manually. If you're doing this from an actual mobile device, using a QR code is highly recommended, so you don't have to copy paste. Under authentication method, I'm going to choose username and password. I'll show you device code in a second. It's very similar. So under the connection name, I'm going to name it something industrials. I'll just call it prod. Okay, we're going to go grab the Entra ID. So that's going to be found. We're going to go back to our tenant. We're going to go to under the manage section. We're going to go to app registrations. We're going to find that application. This page shows us everything that we need. Okay, the first thing I'm going to copy is this client ID. I'm going to hit copy to clipboard, put you over there. Next thing I'm going to do is copy in the environment URL. That's going to come from LCS, or if you have a browser window open with Dynamics, you can copy it from there. Then the next thing you need is the Entra ID. The first part is universal, and you're going to copy the directory tenant ID after it. There you go. So I see login.microsoftonline.com and then the directory tenant ID from Azure. The company I'm working in for this mobile device is TMPL. And I'm not using a broker and my name is going to be Microsoft. I'm going to go ahead and click save there. Now I should be able to click on my industrials production environment, hit connect. because I'm using username and password authentication, it's going to ask me for my username and password. Once you got there, you should be back to normal. This is where you log in as your mobile device users in that are configured in Dynamics 365. Now I'll go ahead and show you the difference between what we just did, which is username and password authentication and device code authentication. So go ahead and hit change connection. I'm gonna go edit connection settings. I'm gonna log out. Okay, signed out successfully. I'm gonna change this to device code so we can see the difference. Nothing much else changes. Still the same information gets put in the mobile device. You hit connect. Once you get this screen, as a administrator, I'm gonna open a new incognito window. This is to differentiate my existing browsers and logins with the login for this device. I'm gonna go to microsoft.com/device login. On the phone or via text, whatever it may be, your user on the floor is going to give you this code to type in. Go ahead and copy that. Type it in. And this is where it's going to ask you for the mobile device's username and password. Once you log in the browser, it's going to ask you to confirm. Once you confirm, and close this browser window, and the mobile device should automatically bring you to the warehouse mobile device user login. And that's it.